Once, in a huge forest, there lived a lion. All the beasts and the birds of the jungle were scared of the lion. No one even dared to go near the cave of the lion. One day, a little mouse was playing hide and seek with his friends in the forest. The friend mouse closed its eyes and all the mice ran in different directions.
Let me run away from the tree and come back when they start searching.
He ran as fast as he could and reached the lion's den. He did not notice the den and went straight to the place where the lion was sleeping. He touched the paws of the lion.
What is it, so sharp?
Suddenly.
Oh my God, it's a lion.
He screamed and the lion woke up. The mice were trapped between the legs of the lion. The lion saw the mouse.
Hey, little one. You are my evening snack today. Good. I need not go out.
The mouse trembled with fear.
Dear King, please leave me. I will be of help to you someday or the other. Why do you laugh, my lord?
You! Are you going to help me?
Please, King, leave me. I will certainly help you one day.
The lion was in a mood to sleep, so he did not bother the mouse much.
I want to sleep now. You better get away from here.
Thank you, my lord.
The mouse went as fast as he could to the forest. A few days passed. One day, as usual, the mouse was playing hide and seek with his friends.
Run, run!
The little mouse ran and finally reached a tree.
Let us hide here.
There he was surprised to see the lion trapped in a net. He went running to the lion. There were tears from the eyes of the lion. There was no one nearby.
Great King, what happened? Who has got you snared in this net?
The lion was surprised to see the little mouse.
Hey, little one, look at me. The hunters have caught me and have gone to bring their vehicle.
Great King, don't worry. I will cut this net and make you free.
Can you?
The mouse wasted no time. He frantically gnawed away at the net and released the lion.
Hooray! Hey, you have saved me. You are correct. Even small friends can be more useful somewhere, someday. Thank you, my friend.
The lion hugged the little mouse. Moral: do not think anyone small. Do not judge people by their appearance. Once in a pond, there was a tortoise. The tortoise was of a grumbling sort. He always used to grumble about his appearance. One fine morning, he was on the bank of the pond.
Hey, little fish, what makes you so happy to jump like this?
Hi, what is that you feel so sad about?
If a fisherman casts his net, you cannot escape. You will be in someone's soup tomorrow.
That is my fate. Let me enjoy this moment. Let tomorrow's sorrow take care of itself tomorrow.
If we could fly like these birds, we can also fly and hide somewhere.
Why do you have to fly?
We can go to far off places faster. None can come near us. We can be safe always.
But even the birds are caught by the hunters. They too cannot escape.
They are fools, but we can escape.
I am not interested in flying. There are problems everywhere. Who knows what problem is there in flying?
You keep quiet. Look at these cranes. They happily gorge themselves and then flying off to another pond in minutes. Look at us.
The fish scarcely gave ear to all his grumbling. It dived into the water and started enjoying itself. An eagle, who was watching all this, decided to help the tortoise.
Hi, friend. Why are you so dull?
The tortoise was surprised to see the eagle.
Who are you?
I am from a far-off land. I am new to this place.
I see. How are the distant lands? Do you get a lot of food there?
It's all the same. Do you want to come there?
I do wish to come, but who will take me there?
I will take you.
The tortoise was surprised.
What? Are you joking?
I mean it. I will take you.
After visiting the place, can you drop me back?
Of course. I will carry you by your neck. You have to be careful.
I will take care. You don't bother about that.
The eagle caught hold of the tortoise by the neck and started flying.
Oh! How nice! Wow! It's amazing!
The eagle flew higher and higher. The tortoise was overjoyed. Suddenly, the eagle flew over a mountain. In a flash of a second, the hard shell of the tortoise hit a small rock in the mountain.
Oh no! Please leave me! Leave me! My back is aching!
Wait! I will drop you back in your place.
The eagle dropped the tortoise back. The tortoise landed in one corner of its pond.
Thank you, friend. But if the rock had been huge, I would have died by now.
I'm sorry.
No problem. It's my fault. I should have been happy with what I have. God knows what each creature deserves and gives its due. I'm really happy in this pond.
It's time for me to return. I take leave.
Bye, friend. Thank you.
It was a silvery stream flowing in the thick forest. An ant was busy collecting food on the banks of the river. Suddenly, the ant slipped and it fell into the stream. The ant was struggling for life, moving up and down the stream.
Oh, help, help! Oh, I'm dying! Help!
A dove, sitting on a tree, saw the ant drowning.
I should do something to save him.
The dove plucked a leaf and threw it down into the stream. The ant climbed onto it and floated in safety to the bank. Days passed. Every day, the ant used to come to the bank for collecting food. Even the dove used to give a few nuts to the ant. The ant and the dove became good friends. One day, the dove was busy cracking nuts, sitting on the tree. And the ant was carrying its food to its place. Suddenly, the ant stopped in its tracks after seeing a hunter. The hunter was aiming his arrow at the dove.
Oh no! I should save my friend! I should do something!
The ant bit the hunter hard in the foot.
Oh! Oh! Stupid ant!
The noise caught the attention of the dove. The dove flew away from the tree. The ant scurried to hide behind a tree.
Shh! I have missed the dove. I should at least kill that stupid ant.
My friend is saved.
The ant moved away from its hiding place and was back on duty. Moral: one good turn deserves an Once a small kingdom was ruled by a king. He was very fond of fun and games. This made all his men very happy. One day,
"My dear ministers, this month I wanted to do something new."
"Your Majesty, last month we had a peacock dance session."
"That was good."
"Last week we made all the clowns dance."
"Yay, that was good. But what about this month?"
"Your Highness, there are a few artists who have come from the kingdom of Aditya. They are good at theatre and poetry.
That's the usual stuff.
Your Majesty, can we make our senior magician perform?
No. Let me think. Bring some trained monkeys to dance.
Excellent idea, my lord. Great idea.
The ministers set out to make the arrangements. The next week, a huge party was arranged. 5 monkeys were brought and were given royal robes and caps. They were trained well to dance. The music was on. The assembly was full. The great show of the monkeys began. The monkeys started to dance.
Look how they dance. Ah, marvelous.
They look cute in the excellent clothes.
One of the ministers, a senior, approached the king, who was admiring the monkeys.
My lord, it is surprising to see these monkeys dance like humans.
True. Look, everyone is enjoying the show.
But my lord, we have to be very careful. Even if there is a slight disturbance, we cannot bring them under control.
No. These monkeys are well trained.
My lord, what you say is true, but one cannot change the basic fact that they are monkeys.
I don't agree with you. They perform so well in front of a big audience. What is going to disturb them? Prove your point, if you can.
My lord, throw a handful of nuts to the monkeys and see the difference.
Okay. Give me the nuts.
The king threw a handful of nuts to the monkeys. Suddenly, all the dancing stopped. The monkeys started competing for the nuts. The monkeys shed their clothes and grappled among themselves for the nuts. The crowd enjoyed this aspect of the show too.
Hey, look!
Oh! That is funnier than the dance.
Ha ha ha! Minister, you are correct. The basic qualities of a person never change.
That's true, my lord.
Moral: appearances are deceptive. It is difficult to change the inborn characteristics. There lived two friends in a village. They were Shyam and Tanu. They were very close friends. One day, Shyam and Tanu decided to go to the nearby city for their business.
Tanu, at what time shall we start tomorrow?
We will start early in the morning, before the crack of dawn.
All right, but we have to cross the forest and go to the city.
So what? Nothing to fear. We can go.
The next day, Tanu and Shyam left in the early hours of the day. The forest was thick and dark.
Tanu, it is still dark. I feel scared.
You will not come across wild animals here. Don't worry. They are on the other side of the forest.
What shall we do if we see wild animals?
What else? We will run as fast as our feet can carry us.
Are you joking? Wild animals can run much faster than us.
Shyam, why do you bother yourself? I am there with you. I know how to climb trees. We both can climb a tree in case of any danger.
Then it's fine.
suddenly.
Tanu, look! I see movement behind the bushes. Shyam, I don't see anything. Your imagination seems to be running riot.
Shyam watched carefully.
Tanu, it's moving. It must be a shadow. Oh no, it's a bear, as dark as the night itself. My God, what will we do now?
After seeing the bear, both trembled in fear. The bear did not notice them, but was approaching in their direction.
Oh Tanu, what will we do now? Shall we run?
When Shyam turned back, he was shocked. Tanu was missing.
Tanu! Tanu! Oh, shh! Don't make noise. I'm coming.
Shyam saw Tanu on top of a tree.
You run away.
Shyam realized the true colors of Tanu. He had an idea. He held his breath and lay on the ground, pretending to be dead. The bear came near him and sniffed at him. He thought that Shyam was dead. The bear paddled off as he did not touch dead bodies. After the bear left, Shyam got up. Tanu came down from the tree.
Shyam, you're very clever. You acted well. Come tell me, what did the bear whisper in your ear?
Shyam was very angry with his friend as he had run away from him at the approach of danger. He made up his mind not to consort with Tanu anymore.
The bear asked me not to be friends with those who do not stand by you in times of crisis.
Tanu bowed his head down in shame. Shyam walked back to the village. Moral: never travel with a friend who deserts you at the approach of danger.